When it comes to producing champagne, there are many secrets to discover and a history as rich as the wine itself. Yet making this celebrated sparkling wine is not as simple as one may think. Essentially, there are two main ways to put the fizz into your drink. First, there's the process of simply pumping carbon dioxide into the liquid, which is used for most soft drinks, beer in kegs, and mass-produced mineral water, as well as cheaper wines. Second, there is natural carbonation through fermentation. This process occurs from yeast consuming sugar in a liquid, which produces both alcohol and carbon dioxide as byproducts. Fermentation actually occurs in all wine, although when producing still wine, winemakers will allow the CO2 to escape before it is finally bottled. For Prosecco and some sparkling wines, however, this CO2 is never allowed to escape. It therefore dissolves into the wine and the wines are bottled sparkling. With champagne, the process to naturally carbonate the wine, known as method champenoise, takes place inside the bottle and is much more complex.
So how champagne is made?
Champagne is a wine. It's a wine. It's not just bubbles. Champagne is a wine fermented twice. First fermentation, like in Burgundy, for example, for white wine, is made under barrels or tanks. So basically, the grape juice becomes wine under the influence of yeasts. And then, you know, it actually could be sold as still wine from Champagne. That existed 100 years ago. Like, it was called Coteau Champenois. It's white, non-sparkling wine from Champagne. But the second fermentation happens in the bottle. And before we seal it, we add some sugar, a little bit, and yeasts. And the yeasts are going to consume the sugar and generate an increase of alcohol content and carbonic pressure because the bottles will be sealed. The second fermentation, which basically generates the carbonic pressure, that happens pretty soon after the yeast and the sugar have been added into the wine. Within 2 months, it's done. You have the pressure.
Already.
But then you have, still you have the yeasts, the body of the yeast which is in the bottle. Uh-huh. And that's going to break itself into smaller pieces. And the longer you keep your bottles in contact with the yeasts, generally speaking, the better your champagne will be. And the finer the bubbles will be in the end. So small bubbles is associated very narrowly with the length of aging of the champagne during the second fermentation. So Diego, if you want, I'm going to take you through our cellars and maybe we shall do a little pit stop in front of the bottles during the second fermentation.
Yeah, let's do that. I'm ready.
Good. So watch your steps. They're a little bit tricky. So here you have what is technically already champagne. The wine is already sparkling, but it's aging. And the aging process for Charles is anything between 5 years and up to 20, 25, 30 years. Yeah, it's massive. And just to try and show you what's happening physically in the bottle, you see you have the bottle. This is, this is a demonstration bottle.
Yeah.
What is that?
That's the yeasts.
That's the yeast.
And we have to get rid of these yeasts before we actually sell it as champagne. So that's when we start to do the remuage or riddling, turn the bottle down. That's going to take a few weeks. And then we will turn the bottle back upside up. And with the pressure, the yeasts, which would be concentrated at the neck, would be evacuated. And then we put the final cork, and then it's champagne. It can be sold as such. That's the secret of sparkling wine and the champagne recipe.
It's amazing.
It takes at least 2.5 years to make most champagne, from picking the grapes to it hitting the shelves. So it's no surprise that champagne commands much higher prices than more simple sparkling wines such as Prosecco. This highly specific method for making sparkling wine is replicated all around the world, from Spain's Cava to Tasmania in Australia and Sussex in the UK. But although the method and even the grapes may be the same, only wines from Champagne can be labelled as such. Look out for the words méthode traditionnelle on the label for wines made in this style that are produced outside of Champagne. It's not just the winemaking techniques that make Champagne so special. This region's incredible soil, climate, culture, and centuries of winemaking history produces unique wines that are found nowhere else in the world.